Thank you. David with his praise, bringing down mountains, Jesus, bringing down mountains, Jesus. We send the fire, Jesus, send the fire, Jesus, send the fire, Jesus, send the fire, Jesus, like you did with Elijah on that mountain, God, burning out impurities, Jesus, burning out unholiness, Jesus, send the fire, send the fire. Send the fire, send the fire. God, we need you to send the fire. Increase the fire, Jesus. Send the fire, Jesus. As we praise you, Jesus, the fire falls. Like it did with Elijah, the fire falls. We can't be the same anymore. We're not going back. We're going forward, Jesus. Send the fire, Jesus. Send the fire, God. An eruption, Jesus. Send the fire, Jesus. Send the fire, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Like lightning from heaven, Jesus. We need a church that is set on fire. Send the fire, Jesus. Send the fire, Jesus. Let it burn. Let it burn. That no water can douse, that no spirit can douse, that no demon in hell can put out, Jesus. Send the fire, God, consuming fire, let it burn.
Shout out to God with the voice of triumph. triumph. Shout out to God with the voice of praise. Shout out to God with the voice of triumph. We lift your name up. 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 Thank you.
take my voice to tell him I was gonna burn his kingdom down.
She was. She's in the hospital telling
him. Mad. Telling him he's dumb if he thinks he's gonna mess up.
That's a song that's like time to be
cast your vision that I have.
That when you pass out, Logan?
That's when I pass out. I've always wanted that cabinet on cabinet.
That's awesome. Did you pass out, Mom, or did you just choose?
No, no. I wanted to lay down. I've just been doing that lately and just saying I dedicate every bit of me. No.
Okay, so it started, there was a fence starting right out front, like in the front yard, right to the road. And it was kind of like a lightning strike, but not really. I don't really know how to explain it. It was just like a big surge of power all of a sudden. Mm-hmm. And the fence was set on fire. And then it kept going all the way down. It went through a bunch of the town, but then eventually it caught up. I didn't see a figure. It was just like kind of a shadow of a figure. And that was the devil. I know for sure it was. And it was like he was placing the fence, but then the fire was too quick. And once it got to the figure, it made all the fence like dissipate. But then it also, I don't know if you've ever seen like what gas looks like whenever you put it on top of a flame and it kind of goes like this and disperses. Mm-hmm. That's what happened to the figure.
Huh.
Wow.
And you know it was the devil?
I know it was the devil. I felt like that's what I felt like I was looking at.
And he was putting the fence there?
Yeah.
He was putting the fence to try to block.
He was putting the fence, and then the surge of power was him, and I felt it was interesting because that was the song y'all were singing, wasn't it? Like, Send the Fire.
Send the Fire.
And
yeah. Huh.
It was very, very powerful when Elijah was praying for people, and, you know, I did the Send the Fire part at first, but I really felt to do it again, to get him to speak, because I feel like it's like with Elijah, the prophets of Baal. Mm-hmm. I feel like he's always really anointed every time he does that song.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Like he's stepping into his name and declaring things with power.
Yes. You know. Well, anyway, is anybody? I don't want to interrupt something else about tonight.
Yeah.
I wasn't Facebook Live, by the way. I did a video just of us, just a video, not Facebook Live. But anyway.
Yeah, I was hoping somebody did.
Yeah, I did. I got it all on video. I met that pastor up at the Billy Graham place.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, was that just yesterday? But he said when he was praying about Chelsea,
mm-hmm.
and I'll tell the backstory, you know, whenever, but just a pastor, and we were praying, and they're doing the same thing we're doing. He just suddenly felt to start having consecutive nights of prayer and praise. He felt to do 50. So they're running through Easter. They're in Kingsport, Tennessee.
That's what Lent does too.
Yeah.
They don't count Sundays.
They don't count Sundays. And we haven't been doing Sundays. So technically we probably should go a little longer.
Yeah.
But when he was praying about Chelsea, and we were all together praying, his wife and me and Alan, what he kept saying is, it's time for us to show that our God is God. And I kept thinking of Elijah's name, you know, Eliyah, my God is God. And that man just kept saying, Pastor Walker kept saying, it's time that we stand up and say, our God is God.
Well, it makes me think of, you remember one Sunday we were in here and y'all all prayed for me. Trenton came up to me and he said, God told him while y'all were praying for me to tell me, rest in the fire. Rest in the revival.
He did. Yes, he did.
Mm-hmm. You know, these nights of prayer, we've had a lot of slower songs, and it's been very, very peaceful and anointed, but it just felt like tonight was a night for fire.
Yeah.
I
just felt, I just felt like something just kind of like snap in me, in a good way. It was like I was feeling God just saying, like, well, what are you waiting on?
Right.
I was feeling what I'm saying, like, what are you waiting on? Are you waiting until you fasted enough? Or are you waiting until you've prayed enough? Not to say that I should pray more, that I shouldn't read the word more, but I just, like, almost felt him saying, like it's time. And I thought of the scene in Interstellar, Mom.
Yeah.
When the spaceship broke, like, exploded because Dr. Mann went AWOL or whatever, and it's spinning away, getting sucked into the orbit of the planet, and it's just spinning, and he's going to try to dock and catch it, basically. And he said, and she says, Cooper, that's impossible. He said, no, it's necessary.
Yeah.
And that's kind of like, I was like hearing that line of the movie, like tonight, like, it's necessary.
Right.
And it's time. And I really felt like, God saying that he has imparted on something in me to pray for people. Mm-hmm. And like, not necessarily, I mean, sure, for healing, I believe we all are supposed to do that.
Sure.
Not even necessarily for healing, but just like praying, and like almost like he's given me the ability to bless people and to like impart fire, I guess, kind of Elijah-esque. Like, I feel like that's something that I need to do more.
Yes.
When I feel it.
I mean, think about Elijah. I mean, you know, Elisha took his mantle. I mean, even Elijah, it was like, he said, well, if you seem to go up, you'll see, you know, the chariot of fire, you'll see.
Yeah.
You'll get the double portion that Elisha asked for. So he really did impart things even to Elisha, had a double portion.
Yeah.
Do you feel anything, Randy?
Like, trust me, it's not.
We're like Ellen.
Oh, yeah.
Whenever she had mentioned Abigail's vision, like the first thing that came to my mind was the walnut. You know, like the walnut and the brain correlation.
Huh.
How it looks like brain is good for the brain, it's healing to the brain.
Huh.
And the name Walnut Cove.
Wow, that's very interesting.
When you said walnut, that didn't even.
I know. Yeah, I was like, is she gonna tell Chelsea to eat walnuts? Like, that's what I was thinking.
No, as soon as she said walnut, I thought walnut cone.
I was sort of thinking, like, you know, because when I look deeper at the picture, you can see like all these names in the walnut itself.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, just as a walnut is healing to the brain, it's brain food, it's omega-3s and all that kind of
right.
stuff.
Right.
Like, God must be healing, obviously, to walnut cone.
Wow. Wow.
So there was an interesting.
That's wild.
It's
super wild. Like when Abigail said that about wanting COVID and brain, it never crossed my mind.
No, I would have never thought of the walnut, but I see that so clearly now. Yeah, literally for walnut trees down in the cove. Huh. I guess they were near Dr. Lash's plantation, you know, down where Hannah lives, down near where it joins the creek, down there somewhere. Well, his plantation went all the way to behind the sit-go down there.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know where those walnut trees are now.
I always wondered if they were still there.
We
had to name it after
something. Huh. Well, wow. Okay, that hits me with something else. When Mandy, I'll just tell you because I think I've told my kids. I can't remember what I've told them. But, you know, yesterday when I was going to the Billy Graham place, I thought, you know, that's a Baptist run thing. But the only people that I reached out to really speak to at length when I said, so do you go to a Baptist church in Tampa, Florida, where you're from? They're like, oh, no, we're Pentecostal. I'm like, oh, okay. And then when we were in the first free tour, I said to the tour guide, an old man, a volunteer, I said, this is our wedding anniversary today. He said, it was only 11 a.m. He said, you're the third couple to come in here today. Tell me it's your wedding anniversary. I said, that's very interesting. By 11 o'clock, three couples, they don't open till 9.
Yeah, that's weird.
And then he said, there was a guy who just left with a beard and said, it's his anniversary. And said, he told me that they're having 50 nights of prayer and praise at his church. That's the guy I was talking about a while ago. And he wasn't in our tour group. And I just said, oh, well, we're doing that, sort of. He said that they've already had like 26 salvations. They've had people bring their drugs to the altar and throw them down and put them in garbage bags and they throw them away. And I said, man, I wish I could talk to that guy, but you know, he'd already gone. But then later, when we were up at the training center, a different place, just sitting on the back deck rocking and rocking chairs, me and Alan, I saw a guy with a beard. And I just felt from the Lord, just go to him. I said, excuse me, sir. He was reading his Bible with his wife. I said, are you the man who's having 50 days of prayer? And he said, yes. And I said, I need to talk to you. And I just started telling him, you know, what's happening out here. And he said, we're on night. He said, we've had 36 nights so far. He said, be honest with you, I'm tired. And he said, I needed refreshing. Here's what he said. And it hit me right now when you brought that up about the walnut. He said, I don't want to quit. I know it's God. He said, but my wife and I are tired and we needed refreshing. So we drove down to the Cove for refreshing. Now that's the name of Billy Graham's training center, is the Cove. I didn't think about that till he said it. I mean, I didn't plan to go there because it's called the Cove. And that's what people have called Walnut Cove for years. Hey, let's go down to the Cove. But he said, we came to the Cove for a refreshing. And I nearly said to him, that's the name of our ministry in Walnut Cove, Times of Refreshing. I did later tell him the name, but I didn't connect it to the Cove. And he's the man that I said, we've just found out my daughter's been taken to the emergency room again. He jumped right up and said, let's all pray right now. We got hands and took off to pray. And he is the one again who said, it's time for us to rise up and say, my God is God. And we're in touch now. It's like going to be like a sister church to us, I believe. But Kingsport, Tennessee. He said that his 12-year-old son was baptized in the Holy Ghost a few weeks ago. But refreshing. He said, we felt to come to the Cove for refreshing.
Well, it kind of goes along with what we were saying tonight. Normally, I don't post a lot of medical stuff on Facebook because I'm, you know, people say crazy stuff and I'm not looking for pity or anything, so I keep it to myself most of the time. But recently I've just felt to post some of it so people could see.
Yeah.
You know, if they don't know some of what I've went through,
yeah,
then when they start seeing miracles in my life, it won't mean as much.
Mm-hmm. People, that man said that.
But people
that man
who
said that.
Who've seen how much I've gone through, mm-hmm, then they're going to be blown away when they see the miracle because they'll understand how big it is.
Mm-hmm. That man said that, Chelsea. He said that his church is putting out there stuff, you know, that they've been battling against. He said, but I know that when people start to see the miracles, mm-hmm, that's why he put it out there. He said that's you just said.
Kind of what I felt, because in the past, mm-hmm, I kind of kept things private because I didn't want to make a big deal about it. But recently, I've felt just put it out there and let people see what happens.
Yeah, yeah.
Kind of feeling while we were playing. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you, Chelsea.
No, I'm just going to say.
I was just kind of feeling while I was playing, like, what kind of a healing ministry you're going to have.
Yeah.
Because I was kind of thinking, like, God, you know, so many people at the well have struggled with so many physical ailments. And you, and you know, so much so in the past few years. I really felt like Chelsea's going to have a real big healing ministry, I feel. Just because of what you've been through.
Yeah. I haven't been afraid with the voice thing or anything. I just really just made me mad.
Yeah,
when we were in the emergency room, you just saw so much works of the devil. It was just
so awful.
I mean, people coming in screaming, someone non-responsive because they overdosed. I mean, a guy committed himself. A police officer brought him in, and he voluntarily committed himself because he was going crazy. You just, people crying in pain, people throwing up. Like, it was insane when we were there. And it just, like, it just you broke my heart, but it made me more fired up because I thought, I want to see all these people healed, mm-hmm, you know? Mm. There's so many hurting people, and